So here we are in a beautiful region of Poland. We are on the southern Poland, on the Dunajec River. Behind my back you can see the river, and also you can see Slovakia, because the river is a natural border with this beautiful country. And as you can see, it's a mountain river. The river is very wild, and wild trouts in the river. Geras is here with me on my invitation.
Hey guys.
And it's the first time for you to fish on this kind of river, right?
Yeah, I traveled actually 1,000 kilometers all the way from Lithuania to properly open trout season. It's a breathtaking area. It's like, to be here is like...
Yeah, it's an amazing place. We are here with the Vanquish Wheel to do some finesse fishing for the wild trouts.
It's mid-April and yeah, conditions still cold actually. Water temperature is around 5 degrees, right? And you need those precise presentations, very finesse fishing, and I think the Vanquish is gonna help us, so we'll see how it goes.
I hope that this river, my river, will be able to give you a nice fish. We have 2 days of fishing, so let's just not take too much time. Blast preparation and hit the water, searching for the nice brown trout. So at the moment we are trying to reach the other side of the river. There is a little bit deeper spot, running not so fast, so there should be, normally they are there. We cannot fish from the other side, it's a Slovakian side, so we are not allowed with the licenses that we have to fish there. We also are not able to go deeper into the water, like standing just in the middle, because of the water running quite fast, so we need to reach those fish. And I really like the advantage of having the long stroke spool on the Vanquish, because it really helps you to cast even with the small lures. Like now I'm using the soft bait with the very light jig head, I'm still able to make a nice cast like 40 meters. So the other thing I really like is on this kind of conditions, this kind of river, when I want to do a very light presentation, of course with the light reel, I also like to use the very light sensitive rods with a solid dip, because it's very easy to get stuck in the stones with your lure, but you really also want to go down to the bottom, to touch the bottom, to really provoke the fish to attack. So solid tip helps you to notice when your lure just touch the stone, and then you know that you need to go up with your lure to make a good presentation and probably, hopefully, get a fish.
beautiful brownie. Not a huge one, but still a fish. Soft bait on a slow running water. I'm happy. Yeah. Let's continue. Some bigger ones. The key point for our trip is to find slow running spots, and this is the exact moment. You can see fast running water here and it comes over there. So I'm trying to cast on the edge and slowly moving to the calmer water. It seems that the trout are still in winter mode and they are resting in calmer spots. And I can even try slow jigging there, which is a bit unusual way for trout fishing for me, but it seems to do the trick at the moment. Well done. Well done, my friend.
Yeah, wow, just look at it. Plenty of rocks underwater. So it's a good spot the fish can hide.
So I tried a few different colors with the soft baits. I think it's time to move back to the one which was working in the previous spot. Maybe it was the color or the form itself. Time to check it again.
I upgraded the size of the lure. I'll try with this trim flat. It's like 6.5 centimeters sinking one. Put a single hooks on it because of the restrictions here.
The idea is to reach the fish in the middle of the river, but I want to go a little bit down the stream, like 100 meters. I see it's a nice spot there.
Yeah, let's try.
Small Polish trout. Got it on a Cardi Folletta. So first fish on the hard bait, which might suggest that they are getting active. Beautiful fish. And yeah, let's release this small one and try to get a bigger one then.
So how are you feeling after first day, Pavel?
I'm a little bit disappointed, but like just a little. God, you know, the fish was missing, like the good fish. It's always like, you know, fulfill the picture, but yeah, still, we got a pretty nice weather. The forecast was like totally opposite in the morning, so I was surprised that a little bit rain, no wind, it was really nice on the water. So I really enjoy fishing, but yeah, the last element was something that I missed. But
for me as well, like mixed feelings. Like I had several strikes to be like really, really hard, and you know, it's like,
yeah, you feel you start to imagining the size of the fish.
I think it was you that kind of fish. Yeah,
it's always like the smallest one hits the hardest way. Yeah, but it's who knows that there are huge trouts in that river, huge ones. Yeah,
at least we did some, you know, research, some scouting around, so we have the sense, the feeling now what to look for.
Yeah,
so I think it could be easier tomorrow.
I know some spots that we can visit tomorrow, and it should be pretty similar to the one that you caught the fish today. So we can try it.
Yeah, good idea. I like this spot.
And that's the nicest thing, like to enjoy like every day on the water fishing.
And yeah, it's brilliant.
Yeah, that's brilliant about it. And now let's just warm up a little bit, get some sleep, and start tomorrow morning.
Yeah, recharge and full attack tomorrow.
Us. I have one idea.
Yeah.
Here everything is fine, with the exception that I think there is a very shallow water. There's a lot of trash, like the branches and so on, some trees underwater. So probably it's an area where the water just pushing some mud and so on. And I don't think it's a good spot for a trout to stay. Yesterday driving here, the guy was standing over there. And I see like a pool here before the water starts to spinning up. And I think it's possible to go like very close to the wall and then maybe try to fish in that area. It is very slippery, so be careful, yeah? And several bigger rocks on the bottom. So we choose this spot. There is a lot of slow water coming. Some big rocks, very big rocks, in the middle of the river. And I think some trout might stand just behind the rocks. It seems like the fish are still in the the winter spots, so they are searching for less current. They are trying to hide, and unfortunately they are also not so active like we would expect, but still systematically I think that we'll achieve and get some nice trout. Personally for me, it's not a target. I wish Geddes could cut a nice trout, honestly. We saw some fish jumping in the middle of the river, a deeper area. So adapting to the situation, we changed the lures for some small box imitation. And we also changed the style of how we fish, because now we are doing something quite similar to what fly fishermen are doing sometimes with the nymph. So we are just letting the lure go slowly on the bottom, just like following the current. Then you just keep a little bit of tension so you know what's going on. So with a light set, like very sensitive rod and reel, you can easily feel what's going on and if there is any fish getting your lure from the bottom at the moment. Yeah, it's a fish. It's a good fish. Yeah, it is a good fish. Oh yes, it's a better one. Oh yes, I really don't want to lose that one. Oh yes, 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 beautiful. And it's not a trout. But still, oh, beautiful fish. Okay, so we have the first decent fish. Not the one that we are searching for, but makes us quite optimistic, right, Geddes?
Yep, it is.
So it's Hondostroma nasus. It's a local species, most likely for Polish, Czech and Slovakia territory. But it's beautiful fish. It has those small dots on the forehead with nice orange fins. Let's release it. Cast like this, put the line on the water, and then you just like shake it a little bit, and that's it. And they are in the middle of the river. Yeah?
Fish on.
Fish. I hope it's a trout, mate.
It should be trout.
Oh, the same. Yeah, my dream
comes true. Yay! Shame it's not a trout, still.
No, better than the trout.
Nice, I'm happy for you, man.
Jesus.
We don't have this fish in Lithuania, it's a local fish, so I'm really happy that I caught a new species. Look at the shape of the mouth. Beautiful fish.
Yay. Nice. Great. Really nice. Next time, take your net with you. Good tip.
Okay,
so the trip is over.
Yeah, we've been fishing 2 days in these beautiful mountains with the Vanquish reel, and I really enjoy it. I mean, the whole nature stuff, the wild life that is going on around you, like, beautiful. And you get the fish, but it wasn't a trout, and really sorry about it.
I didn't break my record on trout, but I caught new species.
Yeah.
Which is a local fish. I think it's the English name is common gnace, right? Yeah. How do you call it in Polish?
In Polish we call it świnka, which is like a piggy because of the shape of the mouth. But a beautiful fish, colorful. It was a really decent fight you made twice.
I caught two nice piggies.
Yeah, yeah, but...
Every spot is different at this river, and you have to try different techniques.
Yeah.
And sometimes like slow jigging, keeping the lure as long as possible in one place, then like nymphing, rolling the lure at the bottom,
yes,
wobblers.
You need to be very precision on your application, on how you fish, targeting, spotting these places where the fish can be. So that's nice. And well, I hope next time you join me when I'll be here and we will get a nice big trout for you.
Thank you, Pavel, for guiding services. Brilliant.
No problem. I hope you enjoy the video, and I hope we'll see you in the next one. So till the next one, thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, guys.
And let's have the last.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you maybe one more.
Yeah,
one
let's go.
Come on.